In this video, I'm going to show you a whole bunch of tips and tricks to edit way faster by using multicams inside of Final Cut Pro. If you realize you wanted to change the camera angle on a whole bunch of different edits in your timeline, you can select all of the different clips, go on up to the top right, and go to your inspector. Then under active video angle, you'll notice that it says mixed values. In here, I can change that over to whichever camera angle I would like to select. So if I wanted to change this over to the first show, I could go ahead and do that. And now all of those changes have been applied. Additionally, a lot of people don't know that you can actually just select an edit point if it has a dotted line and you can delete that. So if you wanted to really clean up this edit, you could go through and clear all of these edit points if you should so desire. And in tandem with that tip, if you want to change just a single shot, make sure you park your playhead over the clip that you would like to change. Then going up here, push option and click on the angle that you would like to use instead. This is going to replace that clip on the timeline rather than creating a cut and changing out that clip here on the timeline. Now with this clip, you'll notice that it has a different audio roll than the other clips. That is because I swapped it with the audio and video mode. You can go over here and just select audio or video only switching if you should so desire. And now when I make the cut, the audio is going to stay the same between the different cuts. But it should also be noted that if you want to, you can select a single clip and go up to the audio inspector. Then I will go ahead and double click on the inspector at the top that will expand things out, and we can see all of the different audio lanes that I've added with these separate clips. So if I wanted to bring in the audio from, say, a crowd camera, or if I wanted to bring in the audio from something like a Zoom recorder that recorded the music independently, I can go ahead and check the boxes on the different clips that I want. If that clip had multiple rolls going on, I can enable or disable those specific elements, cleaning up my audio and making my audio workflow so much easier when it comes to using multicams. And finally, one last hidden tip when it comes to audio is if we go to the top left and make sure we select the audio editing mode, I can push Command and Option, then click on a separate clip, and you'll notice that that has now added in that audio element without me needing to go over to the right side and enabling it here in the audio inspector. When you're working with multicams, you might have noticed on your timeline that every single clip has the exact same name. Sometimes you need to find the different clips based off the camera angle up here in the top left-hand corner. To change this from having just the Act 1 multicam, I can go on over to the film strip. Then if we go to the bottom of that, we'll find the angles. I can enable this and I will also disable the clip names. So now taking a look at our different clips, we can see that this one, the video, is from Show 4, Act 1 on the FX30. Then this next clip is Show 4, Act 1 on the A7S3. Additionally, we can see which audio elements are being used by this audio indicator, audio from Show 4 Act 1 A7S3. If you need to quickly figure out which clip is what on your timeline, this can be a great way to do just that. Whenever I see somebody making a tutorial style video or maybe a video that has keynote like slides, I might see them duplicate one of these clips. Then we'll go into our multicam editor, make sure it's the video mode. We can swap that out. We could shrink it down, bring it down in the corner. Maybe I could even apply my picture in picture effect to that. And we could shrink that down even just a little bit more. Maybe need to disable the audio. It is a lot of steps. And wouldn't it be way better if we could pre-build all of this so we could get to that at the click of a button? To do that, we could go inside of our multicam video. From there, we're gonna create another video lane. Clicking on this down arrow, let's select Add Angle. I'm going to duplicate over whichever video element that I would like. I'll push Option, then click and drag to duplicate that. Then from there, I'm going to select Sync Selection to Monitoring Angle. This is just going to double check that everything is synced up properly because there is nothing worse than having an out of sync multicam clip. From there, we can right click on that video element and select New Compound Clip. Then we can push OK. Finally, I will select the computer element that I would like as a background. I'll push Command C, jump inside of this compound clip that we created by double clicking on it. Then we'll go to the very beginning and push Command V. And I might even just drag this down underneath inside of our video inspector. From there, we can make all of the changes we might possibly need. I could apply my picture in picture effect, shrink this down, bring it to the bottom right hand corner. And so now anytime that I want this specific scene, I can back out. And if we take a look inside of our angle viewer, you'll notice that we have the compound clipped version. So I can go ahead and swap out that clip. And now every time we cut to this scene, we're gonna see the picture in picture. And you could even select the edit point and push Command T to add a transition. And that would allow you to fade out that picture in picture effect if you wanted to. And finally, the last tip I wanna cover is maybe you're not particularly happy with the order of these clips inside of your angle viewer. All you need to do to fix that is go ahead and double click on your multicam. You'll see all of your angles here. And on the far right side, you'll notice these three bars. I can quickly just click and drag any of these elements. And taking a look up here in our viewer, you'll notice that the order has changed. So what I recommend is you put the clip that you want to use the most at the very top, the clip that you want the second most in the second position, and so on and so forth. That way you can just use your number keys to cut through the different angles back on the primary timeline. So I can push one, I can push two, I can push three, so on and so forth, and I can very, very quickly edit my different videos. If this video was helpful to you, then I'm gonna strongly recommend you check out this video where I do a full breakdown of how to use multicams inside of Final Cut Pro. With that being said, thank you so much for watching, and I cannot wait to see you in the next one.